welcome to the debut episode of the Fire Escape Sessions. My name is Carrie. I am your co-host for tonight. So we are taking this speakeasy vibe. We're adding some great cocktails, some comedy, some interviews, some live music. So excited to have you guys. Now, before we kick this off, we do want to do a quick thank you to all of our awesome sponsors. We would not be here, nor would we be a bit tipsy without them. So thank you to our following sponsors, Rabbit Hole, LP Productions, Breaker Box, The Silver Dollar, and those awesome folks over there at the Nitty Gritty. So thank you to our sponsors. Awesome. Now we got some great live music for you tonight. We've got Bennett Wales coming all the way in from Virginia Beach. Let's give it up for Bennett Wales. And our feature for this evening, local favorite, Nellie Pearl's gonna come up here and kick things off for us. Now, without further ado, let me introduce your host for this evening. Up here, strumming away on that guitar from the band 30 Spokes, we got Mr. Chad Graham. Let's hear for Chad. And joining Chad on stage is a gentleman you might have seen on The Last Comic Standing or perhaps performing in Chicago at the Windy City at Second City, Mr. Matt Mulchin. Come on up here.
Very nice.
Oh man, felt good, didn't it?
Yeah, it did. Real good.
Can you? Good to see you. You look a little travel weary.
I am tired.
Off the road. I know you comedians travel around a lot.
I did. But I got lost coming here, and this is a hard town apparently because my phone died.
Oh wow, yeah. Yeah. Well, that happens.
Right? Day and age.
What'd
and
you
I stopped and asked for directions.
Oh,
I said, how do I get to 265? Guy looks at me literally and goes, keep eating.
I mean, you're not that chubby. I mean,
hey, come on,
these
are the jokes. We're from folks.
I mean, you're not that chubby. I mean, you look like you're working towards being fit.
I got a Fitbit. I'm trying.
I don't know what a Fitbit is.
Hey,
but
Shay, yeah, the broads.
did you just interject broads?
I did. I like it. Silver Dollar here, though. It's a nice place.
I mean, it's great.
You like the Christmas decorations they did here, though.
Yeah, it looks beautiful.
Nice?
I mean, I feel like it gives that speakeasy feel.
Yeah.
I mean, I wonder if people that put on a speakeasy back then went to all this trouble. I mean, they've gotten a lot of trouble. Yeah. This looks great in here.
It does. They must have spent minutes on this. This is fantastic.
Oh, wow, yeah. Maybe a little more. I don't know.
Minutes. Folks, this is going to be a long 5 minutes. We need you here.
Yeah, you're a part of this, by the way.
Yeah, I am going through some shit, though.
Are you?
Yeah, well, I can tell.
I mean,
no,
you know.
My therapist, I've had a long conversation with my therapist. Well, my best friend, listen to this. My best friend's dating this girl, and I don't know how to tell him I don't like her.
Well, we've all been there.
Yeah, no, but she's real melancholy and such,
no,
right?
I don't know what you mean.
No, like melancholy. Think about it. She has a head like a melon and a face like a collie. I don't know how to tell him.
You're welcome.
Shut up. That's good. I don't care what anybody
hashtag
says.
Hashtag it. Dog call.
You too, Carrie.
Redhead. That's good.
Wowzers.
Yeah. But, and I met her parents. Wait, do you hear this one? I met her parents, and they were real fastidious. And I don't know how to.
Fastidious. I can't even spell. Well, I can't spell a lot, but I definitely can't spell
that. Went to a state school. But anyway, that means that her dad was really fast, and her mom was really hideous. So.
Oh, wow. I thought she was a nice lady. I mean.
They're only going to get worse.
Back, to how she
we'll worked. Be here all night. All night long.
This is why I get paid the bit bucks. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you are a professional. I mean,
this is a true story. Him and his wife, they were both 80 years old. Their birthday was on the same day, and they're getting a divorce after 62 years.
Well, like high school sweethearts or something?
Yeah.
Wow.
So the judge goes, why do you want to get a divorce after 62 years of marriage? And he actually looks at the judge and goes, well, enough's enough.
Oh, well, I mean, it was a long time.
I got you on sound effects.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yes. Well, I mean, divorce is pretty normal these days, even in the era of how we are dressed, 1920s and 2020s
correct.
For this guy over here. I mean, he is Futurama. But, I mean, divorce is, I mean, that's a day-to-day thing. I mean, I feel like people talk about it.
Well, they do. But there's two guys talking. Did you hear the one guy who went through the divorce? He was talking to his lawyer, and his lawyer said, look, I can fix this, but I can get you $1 million a day for, like, a week. I can get you, like, all the cigars from Mike and his discount smokes down here in Louisville. I can get you all those, and I can get you a lifetime supply of Rabbit Hole bourbon. But there's a catch.
Wow.
Yeah. You got to kill your wife's lawyer.
Ooh.
Guy says, well, okay, but what's the catch?
All right, let's get this guy off of here. He sounds like Vinny Starlito's first wife's lawyer. Get out of here.
I need a drink.
All right, guys, thank you once again for being here. The great Matt Mulchin, the one, the only, the funny, and the handsome. I would like to introduce to you.
I was on Last Comic Standing.
Yeah, you were. And now you're sitting.
It did wonders.
Which is funny as well.
I can't take that away from you.
I would like to introduce to you someone I've become a huge fan of, and he came here all the way from Virginia Beach, Virginia. Yeah. Mr. Bennett Wales.
All right, good evening, everybody. My name is Bennett. I got some songs here for you. This first song is called Virginia Creeper. Not to pay your any mind. Oh yeah, that old Virginia creeper. Fire it up and you pour real slow till you feel your limbs unwind. Devil's in the detail, devil's in the detail of your vine. Vine, you tasted the vine. Yeah, you tasted the vine. Tasted the vine. So fine, fine, fine. The blood and the wine, yeah. The blood and the wine. Blood and the wine. So fine, fine, fine. Suddenly I feel the tingling. Lord knows I want it all. Bell towers start ringing. Lord knows I hear them call. I scream like a child when I close my eyes. I'm lit like the firework on 4th of July. All of my fears are just begging to be regained. Now when you feel the light upon you, you best believe when you hit that tree, it'll clean you out of your sin. When you feel the love on you, tiptoe and knocking at your door, paranoia, come on in. Devil's in the retail, devil's in the retail of your mind. Mind, he's leasing your mind, yeah, he's leasing your mind. Leasing your mind. So fine, fine, fine. The blood and the wine, yeah. The blood and the wine. Blood and the wine. So fine, fine, fine. Suddenly I feel the tingling. Lord knows I want it all. Bell towers start ringing. Lord knows I hear them call. I scream like a child and I close my eyes. I'm lit like a firework on 4th of July. All of my fears are just begging to be regained. I scream like a child when I close my eyes. I'm lit like a firework on 4th of July. All of my fears now rejoicing to be renamed.
Thank you. I'd like to thank all the folks for putting this together, all the folks at Firescape Sessions, everybody, all the sponsors that are involved. Thank y'all so much for being here. This next song is called When She Calls Me Out, and it's about a woman. You wouldn't have guessed that from the title, though.
Turning 5 a.m. and my eyes be burning from cocaine and bourbon. All alone and my heart's a yearning. My demons, my vices come alive and there ain't no surprise when all the good things, everything that I love, I turn and I run. So fiercely independent, no, she won't give no man who ain't worth it. If broke hands, she can mend it. She can dance like it's nobody's business. Coffee black and a whiskey straight. Leaving her is the biggest mistake that I've ever made. Underneath my belt. If I could, I would tell her how much she means. Maybe I should have held on, but so long, and into my demise I must go on. This crying feels like dying. To claim anything else, I'd be lying. You're all the good things, anything that'll love, I'm turning around. Don't blame her when she calls me out.
Thank you.
Y'all give it up, Mr. Bennett Wales. Man, Bennett, it's great to have you here, especially that it's our first episode
yes.
of the Fire Escape Sessions, all the way from Virginia Beach, Virginia, and I know that's a long trek. Tell me a little bit, because I had no idea that sound came out of Virginia Beach. How much does Virginia Beach show through your music?
It doesn't. Plain and simple, it doesn't. No, I mean, Virginia Beach doesn't really have a big blues, you know, scene. It's a lot of, you know, it's kind of an imitation West Coast town, so there's a lot of weird jam bands and stuff like that. But
So I know when you were a kid, you sang in a very prominent children's chorus, which I'm sure didn't have any of that tinge of some dirty blues in it. So where does that background come from? Where do you draw that from?
Well, I think probably, you know, first of all, I'm very, very thankful for the training that I received through the Virginia Children's Chorus. And if I hadn't done that, I probably wouldn't be doing the type of music that I'm doing right now. But I don't know. When I was I lived on the Eastern Shore of Virginia for about a year after I left college, and my granddad gave me a stack of records about a mile high, and they were all old, you know, 30s and 40s blues and jazz records, and he had one of the greatest collections I've ever seen. So, yeah, just started digging into those and just felt right at home, you know, singing that style of music, and so that's kind of how it happened.
So do you feel like all those records you were listening to, especially, I feel like there's probably a special tie that you got those from your granddad. And as you move forward in your musical career, how's that tying in? Are you doing a new thing now with, I believe it's The Relief is the name?
Yeah, so I got a full band. It's called Bennett Wales and The Relief. And The Relief is it's kind of more rock and roll centered. So it's a lot louder and a lot more aggressive. But yeah, I mean, all that stuff ties in. I mean, a lot of the songs that I play tonight is stuff that I play with the full band too. So, you know, it all kind of ties in together.
We're super glad to have you here, especially for the first episode of the Fire Escape Sessions. Everybody give him a big hand. We're glad to have him here all the way from Virginia Beach, Virginia. Once again, Mr. Bennett Wales. Thank you, my friend. Play on.
All right, so this is a newer song. It's called Braver Man, and it goes a little something like this.
I don't know how we started, but I know it's too damn late and too damn cold to come knocking on your door. Feeling so familiar, and I become well acquainted with it all. I'm just constantly at war. You only understand if I can lay my heavy head upon your shoulder. But you're well enough alone, so I let you control me till it's over. When the world begin to whisper evil in my ear, they tell me to surrender, I wanna disappear. They keep the light that feeds me coming underneath my door. I thought I was a braver man, but now I ain't so strong. Followed by a shadow as I wander and I stumble through the dark. They're ever closer to my heel, yet to leave the light on. It's so easy to get lost inside your thoughts. And all the sorrow that you feel, you only understand if I can just extend your hand and pull me closer. But you're well enough alone, so I let you control me till it's over. When the world begins to whisper evil in my ear. They tell me to surrender. I wanna disappear. They keep the light that feeds me coming underneath my door. I thought I was a bear for man, but now I ain't so strong. Circles in my mind. There ain't no safe forever. I'll be a forever man in time. Running round in circles. Circles in my mind. There ain't no safe forever. I'll be a forever man in time. Evil in my ear. They tell me to surrender. I wanna disappear. They keep the laugh that feeds me coming underneath my door. I thought I was a bad for man, but now I ain't so strong.
Thank you. All right, I think I got about one more left in the tank for you guys. Thank y'all so much. I'd like to especially thank my good buddy Alec, who has been putting me up since I got here, and he's been an excellent host. And so I'd like to give a special shout out to him. Thanks for showing me around Louisville. Thanks to all you guys for being here. This last song is called Sugar Walls.
Since first got meeting, I was dead or maybe sleeping, I don't know. Really now sleep, I've been betting that table for so long. Never had time for the money, never made the house for the honey, no, 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 no. She's queen, everybody knows I'm a fool, ain't a friend, so no, 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 no. This will be my last mistake. Darling, tell me what it takes to bring down them walls of sugar and let me come in. What's it mean to be your man? Since first got acquainted, I was patiently waiting for so long. Well, and I was able, I've been begging at the table like your dog. Try just get a little nibble, baby, give me serve me a couple, no, 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 no. She's queen, everybody knows that I'm a fool, ain't a fish, so no, 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 no. This will be my last mistake. Darling, tell me what it takes. Bring down them walls of sugar and let me come in. What's it mean to be your man? I'm just trying to get to know you, trying to help you understand. Don't be going home without a joker of a man. They won't give you what I give you, and you don't want you to be mine. Give me one more shot, and I swear I'll make it right. I'm just trying to get to show you, I just want you to understand. Don't be going home with that joker of a man. They don't give you what I give you, and they don't want you to be mine. Come away with me, and I swear I'll treat you right. This will be my last mistake. Darling, tell me what it takes. Bring down them walls of sugar and let me come in. What's it mean to be your man? What's it mean to be your man? What's it mean to be your man? What's it mean to be your man?
Thank y'all very much.
Give it up for Mr. Bennett Wales.
Bennett Wales.
My friend. You're a giant among men. Excellent job. Excellent job.
Awesome.
Are you guys enjoying yourselves so far? Woo! We've got booze. We've got food. We've got music. We've
cigars.
Got comedy.
Cigars.
We've got cigars. We've got beautiful women.
Yes.
We've got handsome fellas.
I'll drink
Thank
to
you.
That.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, look, it's not every day you see two redheads this good looking in the same room.
I know. It's like a ginger explosion up
yeah.
here.
Yeah. Oh, three. We got three redheads.
Oh, we're starting
the
a club.
Explosion.
The gin. That's weird. Hey, did you... Hey, I got a question. How many perverts does it take to screw in a light bulb?
Oh, God.
I'm scared to answer, but I don't know.
One. But a whole staff of emergency room to remove it.
Oh, wow.
I saw Singer. Some chuckles. There were some chuckles for that
thank
one.
Thank you. Thank you. I got to clap. I got to clap.
Have you been
the
drinking?
One guy who's
have
paid
you been
attention.
Drinking over there? What are you? What are
yes,
you,
I have been drinking.
Did you
but that's
dive
not the point.
Down the rabbit hole over there?
Ah, I see what you did there.
Wow.
I see what you did there. Hey, did you hear the one about the two cannibals?
No, I didn't, but I can't wait to hear it.
Yeah.
This is gonna
so
be good.
There were two cannibals, and they were eating a clown. Now you're not listening to me.
No, I'm getting her to get the hook. Go ahead.
So there were two cannibals. This is not a hook joke. There were two cannibals eating a clown. One cannibal says to the other cannibal, does this taste funny to you?
No.
Hey,
no.
Carrie, can you carry him away?
What do you...
And the giant hook comes up and carries away the bad one.
You can thank me later, folks.
Thank you, Carrie.
We used to be friends, Chad. We used to be friends.
Once again, we're glad you are here. Are you having a great time tonight? So we're trying to bring together a great night of comedy. 20 there was a spew of laughter over here for you radio listeners. When I said comedy, they don't like our jokes, Mr. Mulchin. I'm kind of maybe a little offended.
Get that mic. Here.
Some of these jokes are just for us.
Anyway. We want you guys to really take in the experience that we're having.
Hey, Chad.
Tonight. Yes, sir.
They all can't be gold.
Well, this is all gold tonight.
Thank you, sir.
Long
Thank
ago,
you.
There was entertainment that was all-encompassing, where you had music, and you had comedy, and you had drink, and you had food, and you had great people like all of you. So we want to welcome you once again, and thank you for being here, because you are as big of a part of this performance as these folks. So give yourselves a hand. You are being recorded, so the louder you clap, that means you can go home and you can be like, that was my clapper that they just put on the radio. I don't know about that one. I'll not say that next time. But once again, we are here solely for one reason. The priority is the music. Here in Louisville, Kentucky, we have a great musical culture, and I would like to introduce to you, it is my grand pleasure to introduce to you one of my favorite bands, one of my favorite bands across the land. And if you have not heard them, that's the only way you will not understand the one, the only Nellie Pearl.
Thank you. Thank y'all very much. We're Nellie Pearl. We're from Louisville, Kentucky, and we're fucking happy to be right here.
Oh, my. Hey, guys, can you attest to the fact that what they do live is amazing? Let me hear y'all. Being that I'm a big fan of you guys, I've seen y'all numerous times, and that you are a huge fan of being here in Louisville, can you kind of expand about your place in Louisville's music culture?
Well, that's, man, setting me right up for some failure. We're just humbled to be a part of a really awesome music community. You know, we all came together in this music community, so we love it very much. We're all very close friends, and we love what we do, and we have the Louisville music thing to seem to thank for that, so thanks.
And that's one thing that I noticed, that I see so many friendly faces that came out tonight. I mean, there's literally thousands of people here, radio
thousands,
audience,
Chad.
There are
thousands.
Thousands. We have restricted the volume of their applause. This is when you clap, thousands of people. But the thing that I loved about y'all is kind of a gathering of musicians. So I think one of our local writers said it best, that it is a local super group. And I would agree with that.
That's very nice.
If you guys could kind of expound on how you guys got together, like how you brought this group of musicians together.
I will take 100% credit for that one. me and Sean, actually, we went to high school together, and we started a band here years ago called Blunt Honey. It was like a Avett Brothers ripoff. And then shit, well, yeah, Avett Brothers, that's cool. Let's cheer for them. I don't know, shit kind of like, you know, happens with a band, and people have creative differences.
Yes, definitely.
And so Nellie Pearl started, and Greg had played with us a little bit. He was from north of Indianapolis, and he was just one of the coolest dudes I'd ever met. And I'd actually never even heard Chris play a drum set before. We just hung out, and he'd played some hand percussion and like beat on this wall this one time and like did all this weird percussion shit when we were jamming. And so I thought maybe he would be fun to play with too. And me and Rachel actually met on a dating website. So there is hope for all of you out there. Her boyfriend's here tonight. I'll drink to that. I'll drink to that.
I mean, we can all drink to that.
Everybody drink to that. I like that idea.
So you guys are coming off of Album of the Year for the LMAs, which is a huge deal. When you're a band in a town like Louisville, Kentucky, that really says something. And I think that says something about the community getting behind you guys. And I believe that this last record was funded partially by fans. I mean, 10 grand that people showed up and funded your effort. That says a lot about your
That's legit.
Yeah, that was really lovely. That was wonderful.
Mm-hmm. So when you guys write, is this a collaborative effort where you guys get in one room and you hash it out? Or is it something where, say, this lovely lady brings you a lyric, or you bring a riff, or this guy brings you a beat? How does that develop?
So far it's been kind of like we write the songs individually and bring them to the table. And sometimes they'll add flavor in. But the project kind of started where like I was trying to write weirder songs and getting different musicians doing something different around it. And now like it's to a point where we are progressing past all this material I wrote for the band when we started, and now we're putting new stuff together. So I don't know. We'll see what the next venture brings
for us. I want to revisit one thing you said. You said weirder sounds.
Yeah, just like, you know, like stop fucking bitching about girlfriends or like
well, let's
heartache
hear it.
Or something
hey, Chad.
Like that.
Nellie Pearl, so. One more time. Nellie Pearl.
Live, die.
Thank you.
myself, I've not felt right. Our honey is so sweet, it's better than before. If we could learn to only sleep at night.
Thank you so much. It's a song about getting your head out of your rear, taking control of your situation. This next one's for the children.
They redeem with the doctor's friend.
Thank you all very much. We'd like to play a politically charged number for you. Since fuck we feel politics so hard in Kentucky, sometimes you just gotta sing about it. And when you have a life-size Noah's the Ark down the road, you can feel safe. Being about being comfortable with yourself, whether you're on the right or the left.
We'll be right back.
Ladies and gents.
Is this yours?
How do you feel about Nellie Pearl tonight? I don't believe you heard me. I said, how do you feel about Nellie Pearl tonight? So in commemoration of the first Fire Escape Sessions with our favorite band, Nellie Pearl, we shall open this here bottle of Rabbit Hole Bourbon. And we shall pour it into glasses. And we shall drink. I would like to welcome to the microphone the one and only Mr. Alec Betts, the mind behind.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for coming out. I want to thank you all for coming out. I really appreciate it. This has been a dream of mine for a while. And goddamn, there's some talent on the stage tonight, man. What do you say? Yeah? So, hey, I want to go and thank our sponsors, Rabbit Hole. Thank you so much. I want to thank Denver Clark over at LP Productions. I want to thank Sean Cantley for believing in me and opening up his space up here. And I want to thank Terry Burt for being my first sponsor at Nitty Gritty. Thank you so much, y'all.
Absolutely. Hey, don't forget Discount Smokes, Mike from Discount Smokes. Don't forget him.
Oh, man. And Mike, thanks for coming through, man. Don't go anywhere. The podcast is over, so the listeners at home aren't going to see the rest of this. But you guys here have an encore performance from none other than Nellie Pearl.
Cheers, everybody.
All right, folks. So our live broadcast ends, but our love of live show begins. Hey, thank y'all for being here once again. Y'all stick around because you get a special encore performance. The one and only Nellie Pearl.